What is going on, boys and girls of YouTube? So today I wanted to go back to my roots. The Rudy roots. We used to do, I think it was called like 7 minutes of Smite or something like that, where I would cover a god and I would go out of my way to do it in 7 minutes. It was really because the first video was 7 minutes, but then I carried that on. We're not doing 7 minutes of Smite, but we're going over gods. We're going to talk about some shit. We're going to break some shit down. We're going to start with Danza. It's a new god who is literally one of the strongest gods in the game if played correctly, but there's a massive gap between playing it correctly, playing it incorrectly, and building it correctly and building it incorrectly. So I wanted to jump into it. I want you guys to play this god better. I realize if I actually help enough people play it better, it's going to get nerfed, which is kind of stupid, but I'd rather see you guys. I don't want to play it all the time, so I want to see you guys play it correctly. Go ahead, jump into that. Get you guys taught, know how to play, learn you guys how to play some Danza. And yeah, we'll jump into it. Make sure you guys are subscribed. Hit the subscribe button. Make sure your notifications are on. I never promote notifications, but I found a statistic in my shit where it's like 10% of you guys have notifications on out of 200,000 subs, which kind of adds up to why my views are the way they are for the most time and how many of you come to me and say you never got a notification, or you never saw it in your feed, or you just, for some reason, you didn't see the video. Just click the little bell thingy, turn the notifications on. It's really easy. It's literally one button. And then anytime I post a video, it'll come up. Easy peasy. Like this video if you want me to do more of these god guides, and then drop the gods in the comments that you guys feel is most important or what you want to learn the most. And let's just go ahead and jump into it. So, Danza. Okay, so Danza Boro, however you say this shit. Go over the abilities. First of all, passive. It's he's investing. He's an investment boy. Every time Danza Boro actively gains gold, he stores 10% into one of his money pouches instead. When a pouch is completely filled, Danza gains bonus gold and a permanent physical power increase. So basically, every time you get 10 gold, 1 gold of it goes into his pouch. As soon as it hits 80 gold in the pouch, you get 180 gold. As soon as it hits 140 gold in the pouch the second time, you get 265 gold. You're basically almost doubling your gold as a passive. So that essentially means you will be an item ahead as the game progresses because this gold adds up. You've got, I think it's like 1300 gold. So it's like half of an item. So eventually you will get ahead of your person, even if you are technically even, right? Straightforward. That shouldn't be that confusing. It's not that broken actually, but it is really, really nice to have. Now we got number one, the Fool's Gold. Danza Boro rolls out 3 money bags that pass through and damage enemy minions, but stop on enemy gods. Slowing as they travel, gods hit are damaged and intoxicated. Intoxicated is like Bacchus ultimate drunk. Very annoying to be hit by it. Dropping a gold coin that Danza Boro or his allies can pick up, which provides you 10 gold. This is something that is massively overlooked. Every time you hit your one on somebody, on a separate person, whatever, every time a money bag hits somebody, drop a fucking coin. Understand, that's crazy because you shoot 3 out. That could be 30 gold every time you use your fool's gold. Every time you use your one, that could be 30 gold. That is a lot of gold that adds up. This is more fucking nasty than the dubious savings passive. This is actually crazy. It is super undervalued. Nobody pays attention to this shit. It is nasty. Make sure people on your team know to grab those coins. You need to grab those coins. It's a lot of gold. This isn't some fucking Mario shit where you're just getting one coin. This is 10 gold for every coin. Then when a money bag stops moving, it reveals to be an explosive, which detonates after a short delay. Subsequent hits of the money bag deals 20% damage. The explosion is dope, but that's never something you focus on. The idea with this ability is either to use it to clear, which means you're going to just throw the middle bag because the bags go out left, right, and middle all at the same time. So 3 ways. The middle bag is going to hit your wave, right? That's how you're going to clear. But if you want to do max damage, you want to be point blank range and hit it on them at point blank range. That makes all 3 money bags hit. That drops 30 gold on the ground. It does a f***ing ton of damage. Like, it is a lot of damage. You can burst late game with an ability build up to 700-900 damage. It is crazy. The explosion damage is dope. You don't really pay attention to that too much. Plus the 80% scaling is sick if you're going an ability build. And then the intoxicate is 1.4 seconds at max rank. So that's 1.4 seconds of them wobbling around, freaking out, unable to move. This ability is overtuned when used at point blank range properly. And at max range, it's really not that great. You're just mainly playing it for a little bit of poke and intoxicate proc. Second ability, alluring spirits. This is something a lot of people seem to be massively confused about on both ends, playing the god and playing against the god. Danza Boro takes a swig of his sake bottle, gaining health. So it heals him. Chugs his bottle, heals him. And he throws it in front of him with a there's a slight delay in all this. It takes a second. Throws it in front of him wherever you're targeting in a little circle. Like a small Loki in old two. Bottle of sake applies stacks to the enemy gods in the area, slowing, and upon reaching three stacks, taunts them towards the sake bottle. You throw it, it hits the ground. Anyone in the circle gets a tick and a tick and a tick, and it's like that. Boom, boom, boom. It's not all 1 second, it's boom, boom, boom. So if they stay in there for three boom, boom, booms, they are then taunted back towards the middle. I think it's for 1 second. Yeah, for one whole second or until you do 30% of their health. This is a nasty ability for peeling or setting up. I played this support and made it work. It's fucking crazy. Wouldn't recommend it. But for peeling, for support, and just for finishing off targets, for getting that little bit of extra auto attack damage, because they aren't moving. They're just standing in that one spot, taunted in place. So yeah, it heals you for 110 at max rank. It heals you for just 280 damage at max rank with 70% scaling, another high scaling ability. Slows per stack. So every time it hits, it does slow them for 10%. So it'll slow them to 30%. And then we got the hits to break is 2, 2, 3, 3, 4. Straightforward. Third ability, which is easily one of his best. It might be his best ability when used correctly right now, because it is getting out of this world. You've got Danzaburo creates a field where he moves faster. So it's a big circle. And when he's in the circle, he moves faster in it. He's slow immune in the circle. So when he's running around in the circle, nobody can slow him to stick on him. Takes less basic attack damage. So it's reduced basic attack damage, 20% less damage. So if you're in a one-on-one fight or a melee fucking jungler's on you, or just a jungler in general is on you and beating you, you will out-trade them because you can kite them around. They attack for less damage and you're moving around. You can kite, you're faster. You're faster than them. If he leaves the circle, it turns into a leaf and many other leaves spawn and they mimic his movement. So if you go left, they all go left. If you go right, they all go right. If you go backwards in, they all come backwards in with you. It's really fucking weird to see and hard to play around. As a leaf, you get movement speed up to 40% at max rank. This is the leaf movement speed. You are slow immune and you can pass through enemies. After a short delay from transforming, any hit from enemy gods or if Danzaburo himself attacks, he will revert back. So you'll turn out of a leaf if you're hit by damage or if you attack. Now, what it doesn't say in there, you are untargetable. You are not immune. You are not soul three in the immune form. You are untargetable. Powers will not target you. Nem alt cannot be targeted on you. Neath alt cannot be targeted on you. This means you can turn into a fucking leaf and run straight through a tower, or like this says, you can pass through enemies. That's their deployables too. You can go through your mirror wall, go through your mojo walls, just walk right through that shit. You are untargetable. Nothing can fuck with you when you're in that form. And that's not even the kicker. It's the fact that at max rank, it's on an 9 second cooldown, around 9 seconds. Field and leaf duration is 9 seconds. So if you run around in the field, kite around in it, and then turn into a leaf for the full duration, it's back up right away. It is literally right back up. So it's a spammable ability if you're using the full use of it. I have literally dropped my two, pop my one on somebody, auto attack them a few times in a 1-on-3 situation, use the two to block them from coming in, so dance around it so they gotta walk through it if they want to get to me, which they don't, and then use my three, and then when the abilities come back up, I do it again, and then I use my three until they finally can figure out which leaf I am, which is actually a lot harder than you realize. It is a difficult thing to do in the heat of the moment. I max this ability. I'm mainly focused on the one because of how much damage it is. I level the alt whenever I can, but then I level the three as my other ability. I do not level the two. I level the three. The 40% movement speed is fucking ridiculous. The movement speed of 20% inside the circle is sick. And it is just, this is like the key for running away and doing crazy shit. It's this, the leaf movement speed. For chasing, it's nuts. Then we got the ultimate, which is, I mean, you guys have seen it. You probably haven't seen many people use it very well. It goes around half the map in length. That's the duration of it, is about long enough for you to go in a straight line half the map. That's ridiculous because you control it in one form. So Danzaburo summons a magical leaf, which transforms into a large bamboo rocket. While preparing, Danzaburo can aim the rocket within 180 degrees to lock on enemy gods, or he can refire this ability to become the rocket, also becoming damage immune. This is core for the one. And what I was talking about. So if you're playing normal hunter, you need to stay in the back line. You can prop it up, throw it, pop it up. Oh shit, that's what I want to target. You look at him, boom, fire the rocket. It locks in on him, it goes after him. Great. Or you can press four again when you pull the rocket out. It'll change the targeter into these four arrows, or three arrows, two arrows, I don't know, a couple arrows. And then when the rocket fires, you jump into the rocket and you control the rocket. You get to decide where it goes. That distance when you're in that rocket is ridiculous. You are also damage immune. You can't be hit by damage while you're in it. This will set you up because once you fire the rocket, you'll pass through and damage enemy minions. It'll stop with the first enemy god hit, damaging and stunning them, dealing 50% damage in a large area. So anyone around them gets it for 50%. The damage is 540 damage plus 110% scaling. That's 900 to 1,000 damage late game, if not more if you have red buff, fire giant, any buffs, any potions. Stun duration is 1 second up to 1.4 seconds. So you will ult in. I usually, when I'm jungling, I'm diving anyway. So I'll hit the rock and then hit it again, so I jump into it. I will target a squishy. I will stun them. And as soon as I come out of the stun, I use my one. And that does another 700-800-900 damage because you're at that point blank range where all three of the bags, money bags hit. And then you can auto because you have a Hydra. So ult, this is the jungle version of the combo, is ultimate, hit them, stun them, auto, one, auto. They're dead. They're dead 90% of the time with just that. But then you also have your two and your three to run away or chase. You're actually fairly safe, which is odd. As I said, as an ADC, you probably won't be diving as often. Don't be doing that as often. So you will use the rocket. You'll throw it out as the targeted lock on to whoever you want it to lock on. You will save your one for peel. Any junglers that run after you, you'll hit them with it. It'll intoxicate them. You can use it to kite around. Lots of ways to use this god. He is absolutely ridiculous if you really think about the kit and the synergy between it all. Now I'm going to go over the builds. I popped up an ADC build already because this is my favorite ADC build to see on Danzaboro. You are, in fact, an ability-based ADC. 100%. You have three damaging abilities. One of them sets you up, and then you have an ability that allows you to get off more autos, but is also your way to survive. So I like Transcendence because it's going to get you the power you need. It'll get you the mana you need to spam all day long. You can even spam your two at that point to heal you. And the CDR. The CDR so you can spam your abilities. That's core. Ninja Tabby. So you are, because you are still that auto attack god. You are still auto attacking a lot in the kit. Hit very hard with it. Then Aussie for the lifesteal because you need to get lifesteal into the kit. Fail Not. Fail Not's the best ability or best item in the game, period. Dunzo. And it perfectly synergizes with Danzaboro. It'll put you at 30% CDR. Absolutely core to play this god with CDR. I don't know why you would play this god without CDR. It makes no sense. Gives you your pen you need, and it still gives you power, and it sets you up for critting as soon as you combo somebody. Then you have Wind Demon for more crits, plus you get more penetration, plus you get attack speed that you are kind of lacking because you don't have another attack speed item because you have Fail Not, you have Transcendence. You're already two items down on attack speed. So you get what you need out of Wind Demon. Then you add Atlanta's Bow because you want to make sure you have penetration. You want to make sure you're at that 40% percentage pen. Get you more attack speed that you're lacking, get you some power, and get you the passive to really just synergize with your three. It'll give you basically hasten when you get a kill. And your three synergize with that. You're just zooming. You're untouchable. Then you Poison Star because you outtrade everybody with Poison Star. This is my favorite ADC build. He does work with a standard auto attack build where you're getting Oboe, you're getting Devil's Gloves, Ninja Tabby, Oboe, whatever the fucking other items you're getting, Kittens at Atlantis and all that shit. I don't like that build at all on Danza because you are an ability-based hunter. Now, with that said, that is the ADC auto attack build I would go if I were you guys. Now, the jungle build is something else because it's honestly not even that much different, we're being real. So Ninja Tabby to start off with, you are an auto attack god, as we mentioned a million times. Transcendence, only god besides Apollo in the game I like building Transcendence on. It absolutely slaughters everybody. It is untouchable. It is ridiculous. Fucking love it. Then I go right into a Fail Not. Seems weird because you're going two very expensive items back to back, but it is absolutely worth it. You're still stacking Transcendence at this point anyway. If you want to avoid the Transcendence, you can absolutely do that. And it's not a problem because you don't really miss out on much. And you can go this build. I hate Transcendence in the jungle. I like building on Apollo because it works. I don't think it's necessary for Danza. You can spam a little bit more. But you go Ninja Tabby and Crusher, or you can even swap this out to Warrior Tabby and Crusher. There's no wrong here, to be completely honest. Then you're going Fail Not though. Core, 20% CDR. Then you're going into Hydra's Laments. And honestly, as I do this, you go Hydra's here. You guys want to get online earlier to make sure you're fighting. This would be your core for fighting early game. A lot of you get stuck in a fighting. So we'll swap it up. We won't do what I always do. This is another build. I run variations of the build because they all fucking work. We'll do this. We'll say Ninja Tabby, Crusher, Hydra's. A lot of burst here. This can be Warrior Tabby if you want. Then Fail Not, 30% CDR. Then I go into lifesteal. Always, I love having the lifesteal here. Your amount of ability damage, the healing you get off of your one is fucking crazy. Plus you're already auto attacking a lot anyway. So the soul eater, you get this stacked up really easy at this point. And then you're going into Heartseeker. Now, if you're full 40% CDR, so red pot isn't necessary, you're gonna buy it because you have the extra power. Full damage build, full burst with the Hydras, full combo, as I said, ultimate auto, one auto, they're dead. If they're not, two, and then auto again, and then three to chase or get the fuck out. Core, full build. This could be warrior. You can swap this around however you want, but you need to have Fail Not in the build. I would then sell Ninja Tabby late game for Wind Demon. So you would see me swap out I'll just throw the Windyman here. I would sell Ninja Tabby. I would buy Windyman as my final item. Let's get you a little bit more crit to make sure you're critting a decent amount when you're bursting on people, but you don't need the crit. The crit isn't core. The base stats are what's core. The 45 power to fail not, the percentage pen, and the CDR, because 20% CDR is insane. And this item's just better than Jotun's. You can't buy this on junglers, on regular junglers. You can only buy this on hunters. If you could buy it on junglers, you would buy fail not all the time over Jotun's, but you can't. So here's core build for jungling. Now, you've seen the play, you've heard me break everything down. When you're playing this god, if anyone is solo separated in a team fight or in a lane or in the jungle, you win those 1v1s. This god does not lose very many 1v1s right now. It just doesn't happen. You do need to get comfortable with those combos. You need to get comfortable with the idea that if you hear somebody clearing a buff on the other side of the wall, you don't have vision of them, you can ult them. You can just ult right there. The ult lasts a very long time. You can chase them, you can catch them, you can hit them. I know this video is long. I wanted to be very thorough about breaking it down. I wanted to you'd be able to see gameplay and see how things work and see how it's played and how the builds work and how everything synergizes and how the combos work. Just make sure you're looking at the combos, the synergy, and using that three to with people. I have a million clips of me using my three and then walking into a wall as a leaf 2 feet away and people just run by me, or I'll turn into a leaf and I'll run right through somebody because they won't think it's me. People don't realize how difficult it is. You don't realize when you're using it, or when you haven't played the god, or even when you're playing the god, how hard it is to see which leaf is actually you. It can be very difficult a lot of the time. So get the most out of it. Have fun playing the god. As I said, turn your notifications on so it tells you when I fucking post a YouTube video. Make sure you're subscribed as well. And then hit a like button if you want me to do more of these guides. If you do want me to do more of these guides and you hit that like button, you can drop a comment with what gods you want. I need to be able to look through whatever gods are requested the most. I will run.